This is Audio Visceral. Audio Visceral presents Three Viewings, written by Jeffrey Hatcher and performed by Steve Hendrickson, Lauren Ezzo, and Michelle Myers Berg.
I love you. 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 She almost saw me. Oh, that was a close one. Real heart stopper. The beat coming out of my shirt like a bomb about to explode. Ba-bum, ba-bum, ba-bum. This is all getting much more difficult. I started with just one. I love you. Very quiet, very small, but audible. I love you. Said to the back of her head as she moved through the room, holding hands, smiling, brushing back a tear. If she turns around in the middle of I love you, I thought, she'll catch me. She'll catch me, and she'll hear, and she'll see, and she'll know. She'll catch me, and I'll be happy to be caught. But one I love you wasn't really enough. One I love you was too subtle. So I advanced to two. I love you. I love you. Still, she didn't turn in time. I went to three. I love you. I love you. I love you. Nothing. Now I'm up to nine. And this is the first time she's almost seen me say it. What would I have done if she had? It's been nine times since the first, at Carl Grunwald's funeral. Tessie, in a red jacket, somewhat inappropriate, admittedly, but it stands out, and that's the point. In a red jacket, moving through the room, looking for her flowers, handing out her card. I was standing next to the casket, doing what we funeral directors do, when it struck me. All the years I'd known her. Same town, same people. How we're always flung together. Then suddenly, she's in my mind all the time. First thought at morning, last thought at night. I watched her, me standing next to Carl, Tessie giving her real estate card to Ruth Grunwald. Tessie never presses her card. They always ask. She doesn't push. But they do go home with her card, every time. I looked at her in her red jacket and her black hair and her blue eyes and white skin and said, I love you. Even Carl could have heard me, but Tessie didn't. Tessie came up to me. Carl looks good.
Thanks. He lost a lot of weight in the hospital. 6 weeks, I think we brought him back to snuff.
Tessie smiles. Margaret Mary Walsh approaches the casket and we turn. Tessie and I turn to face Margaret Mary. Together, at the casket, both of us greeting her. Like a couple, the most natural thing in the world. It's been nine times now. Next time I'll have to go up to 10.
Nettie James died yesterday. She was 103, been on the verge of death for 28 years. Coal money, very rich, terrible woman. The Herald Star made up a headline for her obituary that read, Nettie James finally dies. Civic and social leader succumbs after a lifetime of condescension and bullying. They didn't print it. It's a big affair. Private service. I got Tessie in. Not that the James family is going to sell the house on Norton Place, let alone use Tessie's real estate company, but it's good for Tessie to be seen, and I got her on the list. She's in the visitation room. Nettie James looks very small in her casket. She was tissue paper and cobwebs these last few decades. I'm up to 12. I love you. 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 I love you.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.